the sprigs.
Thank you.
different route, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm not sure being with the roadies and the mountain bikers.
See if Discovery accepts this ride.
I don't think you get your heart rate up much here.
Photographs of family members that were killed in the Holocaust. There's a picture of my grandfather in there. He didn't die in the Holocaust, but his four brothers and his father and two uncles died in their village of Lithuania. Upstairs there is the new Reform Synagogue. Used to be next door to the Courts Hospital in Ridge Road. And it's the official consecration of the synagogue tonight. Built and renovated, and we're actually having a function here this evening to celebrate that. That big hall there where you see the red roof, that is the main hall of the Jewish Club, and over 2 million meals were served during the Second World War to visiting soldiers came through and stopped in Durban. That's a little bit of history. It used to be the old Circle Bowling Club over there, which had a number of South African champions. And this grey building here, it looks like a squash court. Now part of the Holocaust Museum actually was the Circle Squash Club. Mm. If anybody ever wants some nice kosher food, there's the most awesome little restaurant there called the Circle Cafe. They do the best salmon blintzes and cheese blintzes and cheesecake.
No bacon.
Not open on Saturdays. But the lady that runs it is renowned for her cheesecakes and her blintzes. And if everyone's got a bit of skellum on the side, no one will find you.
So guys, I hope you all remember that. It's just at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
It's worth a visit.
Chris, yeah. What's that cafe like? It looks like you've had a bit of cheesecake.
She's still practicing with her cleats, eh? So she's on her own, just clipping, going to people's park.
Is it a good ride to practice?
Yeah, no, she's still not ready for it. She only just started practicing properly yesterday.
Is she falling yet?
Sorry? Yeah, she's fallen a couple of times. On the grass, thank goodness. Yeah. Got a couple of bruises to show her.
There's only the cleats, you fall when you stop pretty well.
Yeah.
You've got a soft seat, you haven't remembered.
Yes. It has to become second nature.
Yes. Yeah.
That's a problem. She can't seem to uncleat on demand in a short notice.
Remember this place? A lot of you are too young to remember it. But this is where our friend Mr. McBride put the bomb off here. I had two of my work colleagues were in the bar when it went off. Both of them ended up in hospital, and both of them have left the country since then. But this is where Magoo's was, and this is where the bomb was set off. For those of you who didn't know.
My father-in-law was the guy that arrested him. He arrested him straight afterwards and took him up to where they take him on the farm for the interrogation.
I like the way you said your father-in-law, father. I'm beginning to, you were in there, and I'm beginning to wonder why he's now your ex-father-in-law. All right. This would be beautiful.
Villas at you, and that was one of the first bits of corruption that started when they put that in. It was put out on a tender that never went through the process.
Okay.
And it's probably the most expensive piece of metal in Durban.
At least it hasn't rusted, though.
I'm surprised it's still lying there. Yeah. All right, we're going to head on down here. We're going to go through a few dodgy areas there, just to get an idea of what the other part of Durban looks like.
No, not
that dodgy.
Car back. Yeah, it seems like it.
This is Addington Children's Hospital, as most of you know. You've probably been past 1,000 times. It was recently done up, and it used to house a medical museum. And as you know, the whole building decayed over the years, and I think the museum decayed over the years as well. And one of our members, Nick Marowitz, was in charge of, what's the construction? Norco Construction. They did all the restoration of this building and that building, and that was done about, I think they finished, went off site about 18 months ago. The sad thing about it is, if you have a look at them, the windows are left open, pigeons are going in again, windows left open there. So you wonder actually why we wasted our money restoring it when nobody's going to look after it, and we don't quite know what's going to happen to the rest of it. It's sad that there was actually a museum in there that is no longer. I don't know what they're doing in these buildings. They're doing it in the back building. But nobody's taking care of the place. We're going to go down the road next to it, and you'll see the new addition that they've put onto it, which we do know is operating. I had the pleasure of going in there when they were building it. And then we'll head down the bottom road. Just watch the cars, guys. If this car goes what?
Hey, man.
Watch the road, there comes a taxi. So this is the new wing that they built, which is the children's unit. And we do know that this is actually operating, so something good has come out of the whole thing.
How do they get electricity if there's no meter?
don't need an
EJ. Yeah, well, but then, no, you look there, there's the cables, they're not even connected, so how they put electricity in the building?
Five finger discount. Come on, move out the way, Noel.
Fun.
Thank you.
Melbourne has happened.
So it's a generation.
So called for security.
There was also damage to the ship with that was mine. So the coal loader went
east or whatever. I remember seeing one side broadside when they had that big storm. It's also about 2 years ago.
One big storm was October last year. There have been another one earlier.
Yeah. Is your heart rate gone over 100 yet? Is your heart rate gone over 100?
I think we've got a long track now.
I don't think we'll get any discovery points for this ride.
Might get 50.
It's awesome. Mole's gone missing in action. How much is it?
So it's definitely possible.
It's about six locations, right? Get in the high gear.
One made, the other one is not catching the items.
Or you can make it out, doesn't it? You can go.
I think we were all meant to follow him under the tunnel.
Did you go into the tunnel?
I think we were meant to.
Oh. I know you're not. I'm quiet.
The breakaway group. Thank you.
absolute ball over there.
Thank you.
seems like it, eh? Chilled ride, eh?
6.8k
so far.
Wow.
Is that it?
I thought 9 actually.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, we did the detour. But I don't think my heart rate's gone over 100 yet. Here we go.
Is Margaret doing well on the keys?
She's practicing at the moment.
Yes, I know, but I'm saying,
she's getting better, but she's. So she can't click on demand at the moment's notice, and that's what's worrying her.
This way, guys.
Can you squeeze squircles here?
Thank you.
stuck on the road rather. Mountain biking now.
About
about it, it was 960 kilometers and they did it in 10 days. And imagine riding our bicycles 100 kilometers in 10 days. These guys were on horses. I'm not sure whether they had one horse or several horses, whether they changed along the way. But they had to cross 120 rivers as well. So 96 kilometers each day for 10 days and crossing 120 rivers. I bet he didn't have any fancy Nike shoes or any fancy George Burns or helmet 27.
Yeah, I've ridden this
fucking
river.
Many other people, yeah.
How was that London?
Oh yeah, that is awesome, man.
How many kilometers is that?
160, eh? 100 miles, yeah.
Really, eh?
That is, but most of it is flat, eh?
But what are the weather conditions like?
Terrible. Typical British weather.
No, really.
It's perfect for London.
Yeah. I was there for 3 weeks and that was the only day that was horrible. The rest of the days were beautiful. I'd love to, eh? Just a bit expensive to get there.
Whereabout is it?
It starts in London Central. It's at the Olympic Stadium, Queen Elizabeth Olympic Stadium.
So it's right at the
Central, and then it goes through Central London, past all the landmarks, full road closure, and then out into the Surrey countryside.
Ah.
It does it, goes all the way out into Surrey, and then circuits back via Wimbledon, and finishes down the mall in front of Buckingham Palace.
Ah, amazing,
yeah. Beautiful experience.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And how many entries are
there? Oh, I think there must have been over 30,000, eh?
Really?
Yeah.
Glass.
They work on a ballot system. So 80,000 entrants and only 30,000.
You have to qualify?
No, you don't have to qualify, you just have to be in the lucky draw.
Ah, lucky draw. Yeah. Oh, wow. That's amazing.
Yeah.
You were lucky, eh?
I was, yeah.
Wow. This is the best of the bomber.
It used to be down the bottom.
Monument, that's the word. eight-sided. It used to be down in the bottom of Point Road. It was donated by the Portuguese, but interestingly enough, it was actually built in Glasgow at an ironworks there and shipped out. It used to have clock faces going round, and they had a big clock on the top, but of course got vandalized. In the middle, in the centre, it had a water trough, and it had a statue of Samson on it, sort of holding up the roof. Those, of course, have also been vandalized. It's been moved here, and the guys here have been doing all this restoration work. He rusted it and pulled it.
Should have been in it, not put it.
There's now a question, I believe, with the council about what to do with it.
They designed it.
If they've got any brains,
they'll just
leave it right here.
She's practicing with her kids.
It would have been a good day to practice.
She wouldn't have been coping.
She got taken first.
Too many stops, she would have fallen.
When I was a little girl,
training wheels,
so many flamingos. We used to come here to pick up our hands and all these little cartoons. It's beautiful.
Lots of shrimps and prawns in the bay.
They still here now again.
So you're not old enough.
The reason you can't remember is the brain has died. Right, guys, we're going to go out the gate again, and then we're going to cross over and go down Victoria Embankment for a little while. So please try and keep it single there. We don't want to have any mishaps. And then we're going to turn left.
Let's do a little U-turn here. Okay, this way.
Look at that.
Tag behind there.
Come guys, robots ready, let's stop.
So another little bit of our history. We've all heard of John Ross, I assume.
I should.
Come back, guys. Come back. Come back.
We're not going to the car park.
That's a statue of John Ross just behind me. Assume. John Ross was on a ship that was wrecked when he was 10 years old. I can't remember the year. But when he was 12 years old, John Ross was accompanied by 30 young Zulu males, and they went for medical supplies. They walked from here to Maputo, what is now Maputo, which also happens to be at 960 kilometers. I haven't been able to find out exactly how many days it took them to get there, and I'm not sure how they got back with their medical supplies, but he was 12 years old when he did that. So if any of you guys know how he got back, did he hitch a lift, did he use a mountain bike? Well, as you can see, he was a young boy when he did it, 12 years old. All right, we're going to head up here and then go through the back. Yeah, he brought the disciplines back.
Some bacon eggs now.
Well, me too.
So hungry.
Nah, I didn't know if anything. I don't have
a yogurt
or something.
No, I don't eat banana and that's
it. Is that from Bergville to Midmar?
Yes, apparently, yeah. 145 k.
It's the same road we ride on the
gap. It's a gap run, yeah.
That's a lefty road, though.
Yeah.
That's
the best thing. Yeah, we're going to get up earlier that Sunday morning. We're not going to spend overnight there.
So
I think they start rolling at the 7 in the morning. They try and group it up for 6 and then they start rolling at 8. I think they ask for like an 80 rand contribution because they had like, they give out muffins along the way.
No, that's one fine. Stop.
Yeah, we've got a place for 3 bikes including one.
Okay.
Not mountain bikes, road bikes.
Road bikes.
Yeah.
You don't want to be under some enclosure.
Yeah, yeah.
Done it once.
Maybe a trophy for waiting.
No, you get one ticket.
So, which one actually
use? I don't think I'll get 50 for it. I mean, my heart rate has been 80 for the last. How was it in the States yesterday night?
Yo, man.
Windy with
you. Yeah, good. Right. Stuck in the back as well.
Thank you.
So here we have a little known museum called the Voices of Women.
Oh, trouble.
They relegated them to the back streets. I actually haven't been into it myself, but it's recently moved here. They've been given the premises. They fixed the roofs, and there's a couple of floors inside there where they express themselves by way of beadwork and paintings and so on and so forth, mainly Zulu women from what I can gather. They used to have, or used to be part of a bit of a museum that's in Esther Roberts Road in Glenwood. The name also eludes me. Now I've got the same problem as Bray. The brain doesn't remember all that far back. So yeah, just another interesting little place, and I think maybe it's worth a visit during the week. Come with a few friends in case you need to get some
backup. Yeah, I suppose you could have
been. But yeah,
it would be good practice for her. Sure. I said so, but she said no, she wasn't too good. There's too many stops.
It's
awesome.
It's good.
Yeah,
it's good.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway. Oh, sorry.
Good advice, that's good.
Is the moss shrine, as they call it, Warriors Gate. also a very interesting museum, lots of memorabilia, badges, all sorts of other things on history of the First and Second World Wars. You can park around the back as it says on the sign here, and I mean, no worth of visit. Particularly if you've got kids or grandkids. Some of us have got grandkids. It's well worth bringing them around to have a look at places like this. As you can see, sadly though, we've got electrics around them like we never used to before.
Thank you. Now this is the promotion museum.
Hello.
Many of you are short of money at the moment. Nice couple of doors there. You can unravel a bit. We'll stand here. You guys can peel the copper off from here. You'll notice on the South African voices that Corsi was that youngster that lived with AIDS and became an ambassador for AIDS. He did a lot of talking about AIDS and living with it, etc. Also another interesting museum to pop into if you've got the time. It gives a bit of the history of South Africa from specifically from 94 onwards. There's more emphasis on that period of our history, which a lot of us don't know either, or don't bother to find out about. So also worth a visit. Cemetery?
No.
No. It can only be a graveyard if it's attached to a church.
Oh.
Otherwise, it's a cemetery.
Oh.
Interesting, eh?
Yeah.
For those who didn't know. Okay, so you can see by the headstones here, they're all very similar, all military. But I think the most impressive thing about it is it's been manicured. It's kept like this all the time by the war veteran something. The grass is always cut, there's always some flowers going, flower beds, and nothing's been desecrated yet. Alright, we're gonna head down this way now. We're gonna cross that big intersection. So please be very careful when we cross over that intersection. If the robots change, let's stop and we'll regroup on the other side. We're gonna go straight down but keep left. Past Kingsgate closing. We need to cross over.
come out here
with our bikes.
Yeah.
Hey, go!
That last year, well, I attempted it. I got three punctures along the way, and I got as far as 70 k's.
Really?
I ran out of spares. I couldn't. I had no spares left. I used up all my three punctures. But the road conditions are not the greatest, though.
Memorial. I don't know if anybody knew it existed, but this piece of ground was actually owned by Mahatma Gandhi, and he then got rid of it somewhere around about 1910 or so. And this was recently put up by a company of architects, and the basics of it is to try and keep it like Gandhi was, a very simplistic man, simple in everything that he did, simple. You can see the design, it's very simplistic. It is open for having seminars and conventions and things like that, and a bit of history in it. And it's by appointment. So, yeah, I didn't know it existed until I got bored and found a thing called Google. Right. Across, you know, want to go back here and go down that way.
Yeah, I think it's gone the pavement.
So go down here. Hey, let's go back this way. I want to hit across. Just a pity that the Gandhi Center is so far away.
Taxi.
street cross when you're coming from.
Taking photos.
Check their prices.
Roads existed.
This is the old house museum. Just watch the cars, guys. A bit of a roof. I can't remember the mayor's name, but one of the early mayors of Durban, this was his dwelling, which was then handed over as a museum. Also very interesting to come and have a look at it. It's got period, Victorian period furniture, clothing, dressed up as to suit their time. A lot of the schools come here. Keith and I came here in about 1928, I think, when we were in standard 9 then. I don't know what grade that is.
No, that was the third year.
That was the third year standard 9. They brought us in a bus. What was it? No, wagon. You know, also another very interesting little museum to come to. And the best thing about it is you can see the admission is free, which is quite rare to find these days. You probably have to pay the parking attendant more than you would to get in here. But again, if you've got kids or just for yourselves on it, pop in and have a look at it. It's a very interesting museum to come and have a look at. So that concludes the ride around Durban now. For the guys who want to get some adrenaline flowing, we're going to head back to Pirates, down the Esplanade here, and then choose which way you want to go. We can split the group here. If you want to go along the promenade, or if you want to go along the Brickell Road, or any of those, and we can meet at Pirates for those who come in and have a cup of coffee in the Brickell.
Okay, thank you, Noel.
So we'll meet you at Pirates.
Cancer flow, yeah. What's your price coming up?
Horse. Bergwall, the circular route from Bergwall and ending in Bergwall, yeah. Went round the Woodstock dam.
Start and end in Bergwall.
Yeah.
Then 84K.
Yeah, exactly.
And enjoy it.
Rock the stuff, man. Very, very strong headwinds on the first half of the race, and a lot of climbing as well. And the temperature went up to 37 degrees, so it was all in all, the elements were all against you. There were some downhills. I had to pedal to go downhill more than 25 k's an hour.
Really?
It was such a strong wind there.
Wow.
Must have been about 40 k's an hour.
Wow.
Yeah.
But we've had a lot of wind this last month or two,
eh? It has, eh? More than normal, eh?
Yeah, I mean, normally winds are August, September.
Yes.
But we October, November, and it's still blowing like crazy.
It's crazy.
Can't you see it? See a sun coast over there.
Where's the sun coast pirates?
They don't want to go to the sun coast, they want to go to the pirates. I want bacon and eggs.
Okay.
Every life.
Watch out.
Watch out.
Watch out.
No, I didn't say it. I said maybe.
supposed to go down one of those roads down there.
Yo, slowly, don't run.